Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. On June 25th, NASA announced the first Landing Site Exploration Zone workshop for human missions to the surface of Mars will take place October 27th through 30th at the Lunar and Planetary Institute in Houston. The agency hopes to collect proposals at the conference about which areas on Mars have the best scientific and physical characteristics for humans to safely land, live, and work on the red planet. Once identified, the potential exploration zones could be further imaged by NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter and Mars Odyssey spacecraft to create better resolution maps for mission planning. The Mars Odyssey spacecraft recently completed its 60,000th orbit of the red planet. Odyssey, the longest operating spacecraft ever sent to Mars, has been in Martian orbit for almost 14 years. In that time, it has discovered widespread water ice beneath the planet's surface, and the expectation is that Odyssey will continue to help pave the way for the first humans to journey to Mars in the 2030s. NASA helped ring in the Martian New Year recently at the invitation of the citizens from Mars, Pennsylvania. The celebration of Mars' New Year, which happens about every two Earth years, included 3 days of science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics, or STEAM, activities to encourage young people to pursue careers in these fields of study, which are critical to NASA's journey to Mars. The June 25th Mars Day on the Hill provided an opportunity for NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden and other agency officials to show members of Congress the progress of NASA's journey to Mars. Astronauts Reed Wiseman and Barry Butch Wilmore, in town to share experiences from their recent missions aboard the International Space Station, also were there. The event featured interactive exhibits highlighting NASA's Mars scientific exploration accomplishments and the cross-cutting technologies being developed for the journey that may also be used here on Earth. Reed Wiseman and Butch Wilmore made several other appearances while in the Washington area. On June 22nd, Wilmore, who helped make the first 3D printed part in space, visited the Arlington, Virginia Tech Shop, a do-it-yourself workshop and fabrication studio. While there, he talked about being a maker while in space. The following day, Wiseman shared imagery and stories from his mission during a presentation at NASA headquarters. Both astronauts conducted valuable scientific research while on board the ISS. At NASA's Stennis Space Center, testing continues of the engine that will power the agency's Space Launch System rocket on human missions to Mars and other deep space destinations. The 652nd test was the fourth in the current series of 8 planned test firings to evaluate the design and functionality of the engine. 4 RS-25s will be installed on the completed SLS core stage. Divers at NASA's Neutral Buoyancy Lab, or NBL, in Houston, tested prototype tools designed by students in the Micro-G Neutral Buoyancy Experiment Design Teams, or Micro-G Next program. Micro-G Next challenges college undergrad students to design, build, and test a tool or device that addresses a real and current space exploration problem. The students then oversee the test operations in the simulated microgravity environment of the NBL. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.